News Alert.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, my colleagues. As you know, on December 18th, the House of Representatives upheld its constitutional duty and voted articles of impeachment against the President of the United States, Donald Trump. He said in the course of the debate that he did not uphold his oath of office to protect, preserve, and defend the Constitution of the United States. The President takes a special oath, a little different from the congressional oath. In fact, he takes an oath that was taken by President George Washington, the patriarch of our country, in front of whose picture we stand here. So sad, so tragic for our country that the actions taken by the President to undermine our national security, to violate his oath of office, and to jeopardize the security of our elections, the integrity of our elections, has taken us to this place. So today, we will make history. When we walk down, when the managers walk down the hall, we'll cross a threshold in history, delivering articles of impeachment against the President of the United States for abuse of power and obstruction of the House. As we make that history, we will be making progress for the American people, progress in support of our Constitution, progress in honor of the sacrifice and the vision of our founders, progress in honor of the sacrifice of our men and women in uniform, and progress for the future of our children. Make it be very clear that this President will be held accountable, that no one is above the law, and that no future president should ever entertain the idea that Article 2 says that he can do whatever he wants. And so with that, I will sign the resolution transmitting the articles of impeachment to the Senate, which will be delivered by our managers, of whom I'm very proud. When they bring this over, it will set in motion a process on the Senate side. Probably tomorrow, I don't know their schedule, but it may be as soon as tomorrow, the senators will take an oath of office. They will take a special oath of office to do impartial judges and do impartial justice according to the Constitution and the laws. Let's hope that they uphold that oath that they take tomorrow. And so now I'm very honored to be here with our sixth chairman, who worked so hard to help us uphold the Constitution with their legislating, their investigating, their litigating. You know, the chairman of the Judiciary Committee is part of the managers, Jerry Nadler, Mr. Schiff, the distinguished chairman of the Intelligence Committee, House Select Committee on Intelligence, Congresswoman Maxine Waters, the chair of the Financial Services Committee, Congresswoman Carolyn Maloney, Madam Chair of the Oversight Committee, Congressman, Mr. Chairman, Elliot Engel of the Foreign Affairs Committee, and Richie Neal, Chairman of the Ways and Means Committee, Chairman of the Ways and Means Committee. We thank them for all of their difficult work, and we honor our darling Elijah Cummings, who said, when one day we are dancing with the angels, what would we say about what we did at this difficult time in our country's history? And then I'm very proud that Mr. Nadler and Mr. Schiff are part of our managers, but I want to acknowledge our other managers who are with us, a freshman member, but I shouldn't say freshman. They've been here 1 year, accomplished great things. Congressman Jason Crow of Colorado. Where are we? Congresswoman Val Demings of the state of Florida. Congresswoman Garcia of Texas. Were we all here? Where's Hakeem? Hakeem is Hakeem, our distinguished chair of our caucus, Hakeem Jeffries of New York. Is that everybody? And Zoe Lofgren. This is Zoe's third impeachment. She was for the Nixon impeachment, she was a staffer for a Judiciary Committee member, Don Edwards of California. She was a member of the Judiciary Committee during the Clinton impeachment, and in her own right, a member of the Judiciary Committee, and now a member of the Judiciary, chair of House Administration with overseas elections, important to all of this, and a manager. So with that, I thank them all for their leadership and their service, and I'm now going to proceed to sign the article. Thank you.
Thank you. The Senate will receive a message from the House of Representatives.
Mr. President, a message from the House of Representatives.
Mr. President, I have been directed by the House of Representatives to inform the Senate. The House has passed H. Res. 798, a resolution appointing and authorizing managers for the impeachment trial of Donald John Trump, President of the United States.
The message will be received.
President.
The Majority Leader.
I ask unanimous consent that pursuant to Rule 1 of the Rules and Procedure and Practice, when sitting on impeachment trials, the Secretary of the Senate informed the House of Representatives that the Senate is ready to receive the managers appointed by the House for the purpose of exhibiting articles of impeachment against Donald John Trump, President of the United States, agreeably to the notice communicated to the Senate. Further, that at the hour of 12 noon on Thursday, January 16, 2020, the Senate will receive the managers on the part of the House of Representatives in order that they may present and exhibit the articles of impeachment against Donald John Trump, President of the United States.
Is there any objection? If not, so ordered.
I ask unanimous consent that pursuant to Rules 3 and 4 of the Rules of Procedure and Practice, when sitting on impeachment trials, that at the hour of 2 p.m. on Thursday, January 16, 2020, the Senate proceed to the consideration of the articles of impeachment, and that the presiding officer, through the Secretary of the Senate, notify the Chief Justice of the United States of the time and place fixed for consideration of the articles and request his attendance as presiding officer pursuant to Article 1, Section 3, Clause 6, of the U.S. Constitution.
Is there any objection? So ordered.
I ask unanimous consent that the presiding officer be authorized to appoint a committee of senators, two upon the recommendation of the majority leader and two upon the recommendation of the Democratic leader, to escort the Chief Justice into the Senate chamber. I further ask consent that the Secretary of the Senate be directed to notify the House of Representatives of the time and place fixed for the Senate to proceed upon the impeachment of Donald John Trump in the Senate chamber.
Is there any objection? If not, so ordered.
I ask unanimous consent that access to the Senate wing, the Senate floor, and the Senate chamber galleries during all of the proceedings involving the exhibition of consideration of the articles of impeachment against Donald John Trump, President of the United States, and all times that the Senate is sitting in trial with the Chief Justice of the United States presiding, be in accordance with the allocations and provisions I now send to the desk, and I ask that it be printed in the record.
Is there objection? If not, so ordered.
I ask unanimous consent the Senate proceed to the consideration of S. Res. 471, submitted earlier today.
The clerk will report.
Senate Resolution 471, authorizing the taking of a photograph in the chamber of the United States Senate.
Is there objection to proceeding to the consideration? Without objection, then the Senate will proceed.
I ask unanimous consent the resolution be agreed to and the motion to reconsider be considered made and laid upon the table with no intervening action or debate.
Without objection, so ordered.
Now, Mr. President, for the information of all senators, a few minutes ago, the Senate was notified that the House of Representatives is finally ready to proceed with their articles of impeachment. So by unanimous consent, we have just laid some of the groundwork that will structure the next several days. We've officially invited the House managers to come to the Senate tomorrow at noon to exhibit their articles of impeachment. Then later tomorrow afternoon at 2 p.m., the Chief Justice of the United States will arrive here in the Senate. He will be sworn in by the President pro tem, Senator Grassley. Then the Chief Justice will swear in all of us senators. We'll pledge to rise above the petty factionalism and do justice for our institutions, for our states, and for the nation. And then we will formally notify the White House of our pending trial and summon the President to answer the articles and send his counsel. So the trial will commence in earnest on Tuesday. But first, Mr. President, some important good news for the country. We anticipate the Senate will finish the USMCA tomorrow and send this landmark trade deal to President Trump for his signature. A major victory for the administration, but more importantly, for American families. So let me close with this. This is a difficult time for our country, but this is precisely the kind of time for which the framers created the Senate. I'm confident this body can rise above short-termism and factional fever and serve the long-term best interest of our nation. We can do this, and we must.
Clerk will call the roll.
Mr. Alexander.